Over the weekend, both top Minnesota Republicans and Democrats called for Representative John Thompson to resign. Governor Walz said, quote, "The alleged acts of violence against multiple women outlined in these reports are serious and deeply disturbing." While Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanagan said, quote, "Someone who has allegedly demonstrated this violent pattern of behavior, especially in the presence of children, is unfit to serve in elected office." According to police reports, Thompson was accused 6 times of domestic assault between 2003 to 2011. In at least 2 of the cases, Thompson was charged with domestic assault and disorderly conduct, but the domestic assault charges were dismissed. The Democratic lawmaker responded in a statement Sunday through his attorney, challenging the authenticity of the police reports. Quote, "Mr. Thompson and his wife, the only person whom Mr. Thompson would have been with at the times of these incidents, categorically deny that any of the inflammatory allegations ever occurred." His attorney went on to call it a, quote, "smear campaign by individuals associated with law enforcement groups," and that the police reports were a, quote, "product of the campaign to silence an African-American man who speaks out against powerful and abusive interests." St. Paul police told us they plan to respond to the accusations Monday.
Matter of fact, I was just pulled over Saturday, you know, pretextual stop.
This all comes after Thompson alleged racial profiling after he was pulled over by a St. Paul officer on July 4th. It was later discovered he had a Wisconsin license, leading to questions about his residency. He's currently on trial for a misdemeanor charge accused of interfering with officers during an incident at North Memorial Hospital in 2019. House Minority Leader Kurt Dout says House Republicans have prepared ethics complaints that will be filed Monday if Thompson does not resign by then. The House can expel a member by a 2/3 vote. The governor could then call for a special election to fill the seat. Heidi Wigdahl, CARE 11 News.
We reached out to Representative Thompson and his attorney, who declined an interview with us.